I'm Ed Liss, jukebox collector and music historian. Welcome to another session of Jukebox Bios. Today, we're going to feature this rare and impeccably restored 1941 Wurlitzer, the model Victory H50 Peacock. The Wurlitzer Victory H50, or Peacock, was manufactured by the Rudolph Wurlitzer Company in North Tonawanda, New York, in 1941. It was the only jukebox ever designated as a super deluxe model. Standing tall at 65.5 inches and weighing a hefty 410 pounds, the 850 displayed a commanding presence. The 850 used the 24th selection 78 RPM simplex mechanism matched to an 18-watt tube amplifier and a 15-inch Motorola dynamic range speaker. Fidelity was excellent. Designed by Paul M. Fuller, the 850 was the first jukebox to use an electric selector as opposed to a mechanical one. Coins were deposited in one of three coin slides, one play for a nickel, two for a dime, and five for a quarter. A new feature for authenticating the coins was called a Moto Drive, which when activated would rotate the coins in a closed housing and drop them into the coin box with a plunk. Two make selection lamps were lit on the display console, enabling patrons to make selections. All 24 selection lamps were lit. When the buttons were pressed, the lamp would go out until the mechanism cycled to play the tune. As the turntable rose to the top to meet the tone arm, the lamp would come back on, enabling the selection to be played again. If the lamp was out, you could not make that selection until it was lit. This enabled patrons to see what tunes were already selected. The Model 850 was the first application of Polaroid film used on a commercial scale. It was an exclusive to Wurlitzer at the time, thereby eliminating any competitor from using it. Invented in 1935, it was not commercially viable to use until 1941. The machine's polarizer unit was made up of two spinning Polaroid acetate discs to create a prism effect, breaking up the white light and producing colors. As the discs spun, the colors changed simultaneously. The front door of the machine was a sandwich composed of the front glass with the peacock image screened onto it, the analyzer, which kept the image from showing black spots, the Polaroid film, and a final sheet of clear glass. The result was mesmerizing and caused a sensation wherever the jukebox was placed. The high-quality stained glass displayed two peacocks with large tail feathers looking at the sun. Wurlitzer claimed there was nothing like it on any other phonograph. They are not the raw colors of the spectrum seen when you look into a prism, nor are they like any colors produced by paint or ink. Polaroid colors belong to an entirely unusual and different class known to physicists as the interference spectrum. They were the colors produced commercially without dyes or pigment. Polaroid colors were produced by means of an optical sandwich. All the colors in the peacock panel were produced from ordinary electric light. This white light shined through a layer of Polaroid film. Two circular pieces of Polaroid film were rotated by a motor to change the colors simultaneously all through the pattern. The colors did not clash. The peacock panel modulated from one color to another. Before the eye had a chance to tire of any combination of colors, another combination took its place. Wurlitzer's Polaroid illumination greatly increased the play appeal of the 850. In addition, two bubble tubes on both sides of the peacock glass streamed upwards to complete the animation process. It caused a sensation at the time. The massive cabinet was comprised of walnut and paldeo wood veneers imported from the Philippines and Malaysia. The quality was top-notch. The title board on the front panel was made from the same pattern that was used on the dashboard of the 1941 Cadillac. Formed multicolored Catalan plastic pieces hugged the top sides of the machine, which were adorned with metal castings around the cabinet. The back door mural was illuminated with a peacock feather design that gave the machine a massive look. Overall, the Wurlitzer Victory 850 was visually stunning. The Model 850 is extremely rare and is considered the holy grail of jukeboxes. It took me 25 years to acquire it and another 3 years to bring it up to museum quality condition. The mechanism was restored by guru Frank Hamway, and the Model 501 amplifier was restored to perfection by the legendary John Wiesner. In August 1935, Benny Goodman was completing a failed cross-country tour that ended at the Palomar Ballroom in Los Angeles. The band was not allowed to play their own style of swing music due to the hall managers insisting they play sweet music instead. The band was on the verge of breaking up, and all were disillusioned. The hall was filled to capacity with over 8,000 standing attendees. At the start of their second set, drummer Gene Krupa declared to Goodman, "Benny, if we have to go down, let's go down swinging." With nothing to lose, they pulled out their Fletcher Henderson arrangement of King Porter's Stomp and blew the roof off the place, receiving a 10-minute ovation at the end from their screaming, delirious fans. The 10-year big band era had officially begun. Here is the original 78 RPM recording that started it all. Listen to how the tune builds to an incredible climax that created a sensation on that momentous night in 1935. The Wurlitzer Victory 850 was the most visually stunning jukebox ever produced. I am both humbled and privileged to own it. Thank you. I really hope you enjoyed that. For Jukebox Bios, I'm Ed Liss. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.